Hey, what's up, everybody? Welcome to another top five video. And this time around, we are talking about the top five opponents in anime that you would not want to face. The idea behind this video is that these characters have some ability that makes it almost, if not entirely impossible, to defeat them. So let's get started with number five. At number five, we have Natsu Dragneel from Fairy Tail. And what else do I gotta say? He's a shonen protagonist. So no matter how many times he's defeated by an enemy, he always comes back stronger. And with this character in particular, he is a very keen fighter. So while he does have the strength to back up his abilities, he's also able to learn and pick up on fighting styles while only being exposed to them for a short period of time. He's also relentless in trying to train himself up to become stronger on a regular basis, even taking an entire year to train up to become even more powerful to harness an ability left to him by his father. So if you ever come across Natsu, you might take him down once, but it's not happening a second time. Coming in at number four is Bon from the Seven Deadly Sins, and while there are other sins on the list who might be more difficult to fight as opponents, there's one thing that makes Bon impossible to defeat as an opponent, which is the fact that, well, he's immortal. So on top of the fact that he is already an extremely strong and very skilled fighter, no matter how many times you mutilate him, decapitate him, cut him in half, mystify him, which actually happened in one of the episodes, he will always come back in one form or another. These abilities would have normally put him a bit higher on the list, but there have been instances in the show that have sort of demonstrated the ability to stop him, which can technically qualify as a defeat. It's just that you're only temporarily stopping him. He will always come back. Coming in at number three, we have Goku from Dragon Ball, Dragon Ball Z, Super, a lot of different shows, but we have Goku, and he's on this list for one particular reason. He is an extremely versatile and capable fighter, and will stop at nothing to become the strongest being in the universe. He has trained with the strongest fighters on Earth, all the way up to gods, so he's pretty well adept at fighting. Basically, Goku's existence is to become the strongest fighter, and he is a relentless trainer. He knows how to fight. He is insanely powerful, and while he can be killed, usually the deaths we've seen in the shows are because of his self-sacrifice and not actually being killed by his enemies, with a few exceptions. And even if he does die, we've seen him come back multiple times, and at this point the dude's training with gods and exceeding some gods' abilities. So I would call him a pretty capable fighter and worthy of the number three spot. Now, the number two and number one spots were in close contention with one another for quite a while, and I actually had to go back and watch a few episodes of each show to sort of make my decision, but I ended up settling in with number two being Alucard from Hellsing Ultimate and the Hellsing series. Now, Alucard is a vampire, an extremely powerful magical being, and quite honestly, it takes almost everything you have and more to defeat him, and it was only through a very clever Nazi leader who was able to sort of piece together a way to stop Alucard that they were able to defeat him. But up until that point, every enemy that he came across, he would literally just not allow himself to be killed by this enemy. This is a character who craves death, but he craves a specific death from a specific type of enemy, and unfortunately, he's not gotten that yet, so no matter who he faces off against, if they are not considered in his eyes to be a worthy opponent that may kill him, he's not gonna die. So unless you can find an androgynous physical representation of Schrodinger's cat and have it cut its throat and fall into a vat of blood that Alucard's currently drinking, you're not actually gonna be able to defeat him, and even with him being defeated in that way, he'll come back at some point anyway. It just might take a while. And at number one, I don't think this is gonna come as a surprise to anybody, is Saitama from One Punch Man. I mean, what can I say? It's Saitama. We've had no other characters in anime who have been this unreasonably overpowered. You can throw anything you want at him. He's gonna take it in stride. And I mean, for God's sakes, there's comics out there of him fighting gods. Let's be real here. There's no way that any of us mortal beings are going to be able to stand toe-to-toe with a character this powerful. I mean, you want a good example of it? Check out the fight between Genos and Saitama. There is just no competition with these two. He is leagues above anything you throw at him, and he's just impossible to defeat. And that's it, everybody. Those are the top five anime characters you would not want to see standing on the other side of a battlefield looking to fight you, because it wouldn't turn out well for you. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to like, leave a comment if you got ideas for other videos like this. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. I'd love to hear from you. make sure to subscribe so you can see more stuff like that. And apart from that, yeah, I'll see you guys in the next video. Make sure to be there and have a good one.